As a result of the incident yesterday, we can confirm that there have been 4 residential halls damaged, as well as Winslow Cafeteria. These include Hester, Richmond, Clark, and Hart. The extent of that damage is still being assessed. There are some other facilities with minor damage, but not at the level of these. We told you last night that any students participating in student camps or that were on campus with the summer, taking summer courses, that were relocated to other facilities on campus. Those other facilities on campus have been cleared as safe, and those students will remain in those facilities on campus. Tomorrow, there will be a structural engineer on site working with the Incident Command Center to assess the structural stability of Richmond Hall. This will be just the beginning of this process, and we would expect that it'll take several days. We've had some questions about individuals who had cars on campus that were parked in areas surrounding the area. I can tell you that the parking lot south of Clark Street and the parking lot around the residential circle have been cleared, and public safety is currently in the process of working to identify the owners of those vehicles, and they will work to make sure that those owners are able to access the vehicles and remove them. There was a question about summer camps on campus. So there were 3 summer camps on campus as of yesterday when the incident happened, GSP, CHA, and the Ames program. All of those students, again, are accounted for and have been relocated to other campus facilities. Counseling services have been made available to any students in those programs who needed them. At this time, the university is making plans to ensure that all other summer camp programs will continue as originally planned, with the exception of one, which is we did have an elite basketball camp that was scheduled to be held in the CFSB Center beginning tomorrow. We have made the decision to cancel that simply because the power is off in CFSB as a safety precaution. So they are being, they're made available to individuals participating in the camp or within the summer school program. Individuals that are participating in those camps should coordinate with their camp director if they feel they would like to take part in those counseling services. At this point, we do not believe that the incident yesterday will prevent the university from starting classes as originally scheduled in the fall. We are going to be working in the next couple of weeks to make housing assignments and make sure that students, our goal is that any student who wants to live on campus will have the opportunity to live on campus. We believe we can accommodate that. And we do intend at this point to start classes August 15th, just like we had originally planned. We will make available information regarding insurance claims. We do advise students to have renter's insurance, but we will make sure that they have access to insurance information if they would like to file that.